Hello everyone, Godblaze here, and welcome back to another episode of Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone for the Game Boy Color. In the last episode, we took the Dragon Norbert, the Norwegian Ridgeback, up to the top of the Astronomy Tower. However, we forgot the invisibility cloak on the way back down, were caught, and ended up costing Gryffindor 150 house points. And now the entire school hates us except for some rude Slytherins. Really, it is not a good time to be Harry Potter. Anyways, we have detention now and we must go talk to Hagrid down in his hut to see what our detention is. No, no, not again. Please. That sounds like cruel. Mumble, mumble, gaw. Wonderful dialogue. Alright, alright. I'll tell you. That can't be good. I guess we could explore it, but really, do we want to get in more trouble? Let's not bother exploring that room. Let's just head on down here. Here's Hermione, Neville, and Malfoy.
Hermione, I just heard Quirrell talking to someone. He sounded afraid. It must have been Snape again. I think he's going to tell Snape how to get to the stone. We have to go to Dumbledore. That's what we should have done ages ago. But we've got no proof, and I'm not supposed to know about the stone or Fluffy at all.
Follow me. I bet you'll think twice about breaking a school rule again, won't you? Well, given Harry and his friend's track record through the remaining years, yeah, no, they don't really think twice. Sorry, Filch. Anyways, here we go. On out into the Hogwarts grounds. It's a pity they banned the old punishments. I still have the chains in my office. Wonderful. Anyways, here we go, out onto the Hogwarts grounds, and there's some interesting puddles of stuff all over the grounds here. Anyways, let's just continue on down to the other side of Hagrid's hut. I do have to wonder, though, if Hagrid volunteered to be the one giving us our detention out of guilt due to the fact that he is partially responsible. Well, Mr. High and Mighty Harry Potter joins us at last. Wait here for Hagrid, and don't run off. It'll be worse for you if you do. And thankfully Filch is out of our hair, at least. And here's Hagrid and his dog, Fluffy. Not Fluffy, Fang, sorry. Wrong dog whose name starts with the letter F. Whoops.
Evening. Ready for a walk in the woods?
I'm not going into that forest.
You're if you want to stay at Hogwarts. Look here, that silvery stuff on the ground is unicorn blood. There's a unicorn in there that's hurt badly. We're gonna find the poor thing.
What happens if what hurt the unicorn finds us first?
Nothing in the forest will hurt you if you stay with me or Fang. Keep to the path. We're gonna split into two parties to search.
If I'm going in there, I want Fang.
Alright, so me, Harry, and Hermione will go one way. Malfoy, you go with Neville and Fang. If anyone gets in trouble, send up red sparks with your wand. And I warn you, you can take Fang, but he's a bloody coward.
So I just like that line from the movie. Can't remember if it's in the book. And oh joy, the Forbidden Forest has the depressing music from the Gore's bathroom. We are in the first section of the Forbidden Forest. Yes, the Forbidden Forest is pretty darn big. So big that it's split up into multiple sections like the Hogwarts grounds. And is, well, unlike the Hogwarts grounds, it tells you what sections it is in. You're pretty much stuck here until you find your way out. We are now in the second section of the Forbidden Forest. It's very maze-like, and there are lots of enemies here that you only see here, I do believe. Let's see. What do we have? Oh, wonderful. You guys. If I see a turtle, I flee. It's just rule of thumb. So yes, anyways, this place is a bit of a maze. Like, which way do I want to go? Into a magical encounter, that's the way I want to go. Oh my gosh, no. Unless you're, like, ridiculously weak and... You know what? Fine. Let's see if maybe I can do something against you with these sparkles. Like, how much damage did that even do here? I mean, I could... Oh, let's see. I could possibly take this guy out here. I could defeat a tortoise, finally! Yay! Okay, one's down. Now I just need to go and let's see. You're green, so let's try Formilius Duo here. See, maybe that's your weakness. No, it's not. Should have just stuck with the sparkles then. Thankfully, I'm close to a level up, so this may push me over and fully heal me, anyways. Okay, yeah, you'll reach the sparkles. Good to know. A lot of health, though. Guess I could talk about some other things. I did go and try to find a map to help me through the Forbidden Forest here. I'll admit that, because this place gets me lost very easily. Unfortunately, though, the moment I booted up the internet to go and look for a map, the internet went out. Like, not just here, like, the whole area lost its internet, so yeah. Anyways, there's our new level. So, yes, it's just... Oh, that was a dead end anyways, huh? Okay, well, then we continue on this way, I suppose. No, you're a dead end too. Okay, wonderful. I guess I could try to figure out something to go and... Wait, what? Am I missing something? Did I miss an entire path? Oh, this is gonna be fun, guys. Can't you tell? Hello. I completely missed this. There's definitely collectibles here and there. I don't remember well, though. And wait, what? I didn't even see a magical encounter, did you all? That is... Okay, I mean, this is one of the weaker ones, so I'll fight it, but... I didn't even see one. It must have been, like, the exact frame it appeared or something. Okay. Anyways, I guess I could talk about just random stuff as I try to make my way through the forest here. Is, something I remembered while just kind of looking up at... Wanted to see if I could try to find beta secrets for this game. Unfortunately, I'm going to either have to keep looking, or no beta secrets are known. But, yeah, so... I forgot about one interesting thing that was learned about a year or two ago now, is that when Harry Potter was still young, series-wise, like only... 3 or 4 books in the series were out. There was that point in time when J.K. Rowling was going around looking for people to go and adapt the series into movies and video games and stuff. And so everyone started going and trying to go and get their hands on the Harry Potter series. Of course, Warner Brothers, as we all know, is the ones who won that. But there were also people like Sony and Paramount, and I think Disney even was part of it. But it wasn't just movie companies. Oh, hello there. Try and keep up, Harry. The forest is dangerous. Okay, and onward to the next section we go. You just keep on walking. No sign of anything to hurt a unicorn with so far, though. But what's this?
Who's there? Oh, it's you.
Good evening, Hagrid.
This is Harry Potter and Hermione Granger, students up at the school. And this is Ronan. He's a centaur.
We noticed.
There's a unicorn been hurt. Have you seen anything unusual?
Mars is unusually bright tonight.
I meant something nearby.
The forest holds many secrets.
Nice of you to help. Keep.
Nice of you to help it keep him. Nice of you to help it keep him.
Secret. Oh, okay.
Words not properly adjust in. Make sense in head. I don't know. Just.
Brain fart, I guess.
Hello, Hagrid.
Hello, Bane. As I was just asking Ronan here, have you seen anything unusual?
Mars is unusually bright this evening. You're unanimous on that one. We have to go. If either of you do see anything unusual of a more local nature, let me know.
So anyways, as I was saying before that cutscene occurred, and we met these centaurs, we should not help those whom the stars say or do. Oh, thank you?
Okay, well, as I was going to say is, of the many different companies that were trying to go and get the rights to Harry Potter, one of them was actually Nintendo. And Nintendo actually came up with a few pieces of concept art, only a couple of which have been shown off on the internet since then, and they actually were trying to go and get the exclusive rights to the Harry Potter video game. Now, whether or not this would have made the movies never happen or not, we don't know, but they actually were trying to get the exclusive rights to the Harry Potter series at one point in time, along with all the other companies. Now, obviously, they lost, and while they do have the Harry Potter games in those systems, they came to all the other systems as well. But it's just an interesting little tidbit that's occurred to... Well, just a little interesting tidbit that I remembered, so yeah. Anyways, let's see, I'll go a little bit further into the woods. And, let's see, we're stuck in a dead end. Moving on. And, you know what? I think we'll just leave it at this crossroads here. We've entered the Forbidden Forest. We are getting lost in the Forbidden Forest. And apparently, according to the centaurs, they should not help those who are doomed. Wonderful news for us, isn't it? So, yes. And, one quick warning. I do believe if you get knocked out in battle during this segment of the game, you get sent back to the start of the forest. So, whatever you do, do not get knocked out in battle in this section of the game, lest you have to walk the entire way through the forest back. You don't have the hospital ring, you don't have Fred and George's shop either during this section. It's actually a kind of harder section in my opinion because of that. But anyways, this is Gardeblaze, and I will see you next time. So long, everyone.